We're going to be working inside confined spaces, inside vaults, inside conduit, not your cookie cutter shoring system that we normally build. This is all our system we construct this week. It's a 50-hour class. All of them takes a little bit of thinking outside of the box.
The level four course takes you into those slope floors, the real operational scenarios that you're going to see in a disaster.
Where that victim is going to be trapped is going to be on the interior, so getting in there and doing the small stuff and being able to stabilize the interior of the structure, that's still, you know, one of the hardest parts, because that's actually the tunneling part of what we do.
We have to secure the outside of the building and pull it to the inside, a stable interior portion of the building.
A lot of times that's what's tying the building together. So if you were to lose that, you lose floors, you lose walls, that kind of stuff. So
everything has to be fabricated pretty much on the outside, brought in and then put together in a very small area. You have to find the good part on the back side of the building, grab the damaged stuff in the front securely, and pull it back together, marry it together. So again, that's something that's outside of what we normally do on a regular basis.
It's another tool in our toolbox. We can tie something back, make the area safe for ourselves and people working in the area.
On the inside, you never know what you're going to find. You can have the roof that's collapsed on you, the walls have moved on you, and you've got to go in and find those unique angles and then make sure that everything is nice and square and holds it in place.
You take the basic concepts of collecting the load, transferring it, redistributing it, but now you take that into a round environment. And it's a whole different line of thinking.
We're going up and making sure like the top portion of a structure is stable so that we could get in underneath it and be able to do some work, be able to do some rescue.
We were stacking sloped floors on top of sloped floors, multiple angles where we're coming in at different angles instead of flat to a sloped floor. And that's something that we'd never done before.
It's a totally different set of tools that you have to be able to use to shore those, make that area safe, and make it so we can get our crews in there to get to somebody and get them brought back out. The instructors down here at TEEX, in all the courses I've taken, have had that experience behind them, and they've been phenomenal to work with.
And they're always approachable. They'll ask any of your questions, and you know, hey, if you've seen something, they'll pull you aside and give you real world experience.
Things aren't always square, things aren't always round, and they show you how to move around in that environment and get past it and keep moving.
It's going to expand your background, especially in the technical rescue team area, and it's going to make you a whole lot more marketable to be able to be on some specialized teams. You'll have a skill set that not everybody's going to have.
If you want some of the very best training that's out there, I'd say come here. I mean, if you're prepared to work, it's going to be great. You're going to learn some great skills. If that's what you're in for, I'd say this is your place.